This is the setting of the beginning of the Outer Hebrides run. Complete white sandy beach with turquoise blue sea. It's not your, not the first scene that jumps to your mind when you are thinking of the Outer Hebrides in the north of Scotland. I think probably the Windstopper jacket more comes to mind. But what a glorious place to be experiencing the beginning of such an incredible journey.
My first point of interest, which is this, it's just plane wreckage from a plane crash from May 1944.
Itchy, I'm smelly. So around 40 kilometers wearing this top today, and now I'm gonna sleep in it.
Woken up and it's nice outside, except it's damp, and that means there's midges and there's millions of them. They're just swarming. I put on my Avon Skinzo Soft, but I'm having to cook in my tent because it's just swarming with insects out there.
This is where I camped last night. You can see this is nice and properly Scottish. Heather, peat bogs here. The coast, mountains off to the distance. One of the sad things about running across these places is that you spend your whole time thinking about using your energy to get from A to B, when all you really want to do is go up those mountains. I'd love to trek up there today, but or there, but there in particular. But I've got to think about my knees, I've got to think about my body, I've got to think about where I can get food and water. So everything's about moving forward, not staying still and having a look around and enjoying stuff. So today I have done about 50 kilometers and it's brought me to the Northwest Agricultural Show, which is a great saviour for me because they had a loo and they had water. And another amazing place to be camping tonight. This is where I'm gonna peg up. Beautiful white sandy beach overlooking the ocean. I burnt over 5,500 calories today, and this packet of food is gonna give me 228 calories. Getting so close to replacing what I need. Thank you, Ainsley. My jet boil has lost its jet, which making breakfast a little difficult to prepare. Just run 27 miles from the last place and I had a sandwich in my backpack in a bag. The bag is split and that is now my coronation chicken sandwich.
Very cute sign saying otters are crossing. Love that sign. Holy guacamole! How beautiful is this? This is amazeballs! This is what it's all about. Get the geese, the ducks, the mountains, the water! It's amazing! A lot of people may think this is miserable, or looks miserable, but look where I'm running! How cool is this? Whew! I just had to do a Paula Radcliffe up there. Oh, that was a close run. Suffering slightly from overindulgence of caffeine and sugar from a very nice cafe back there, which is making the journey somewhat unpleasant. I'm just gonna embark up this hill and I've got to do another 20k today, so it's all right. It's kind of lunchtime, so I've got all day to do it, but stomach is really causing problems. I think it's time for a shortcut. cars are going all the way that way, all the way that way, and all the way that way. So why don't I just go that way?
Trying to find a place for ages. I'm in the middle of a moor. Everything is soaking wet, so you can't get a tent anywhere. So I am in a lay-by on a very uneven piece of ground, and it's raining outside, and everything stinks. My feet. Look at my feet. Look at my feet. Tonight we are going gourmet. We have thin oat cakes and cheddar cheese. We have half a Snickers bar, some dry roasted peanuts, some sardines and tomato sauce, some dressed crab, and a pot noodle. Absolutely no sleep last night. It's like sleeping in a plastic bag. How am I meant to run today?
Some days it is a lot harder to get motivated than others. And bizarrely, it's always when I'm in towns. I just get stuck. But I'm heading that way now. I'm gonna go the off-road route first. But I think taking something a bit more difficult will be more inspiring. I'm just not feeling it.
I'm in quite an extreme amount of pain at the moment. Not from my knees, not from anything to do with running. Purely this sodding rucksack. It's just digging deeper and deeper into my back. This is the Bridge to Nowhere, or as it's probably called, the Garry Bridge. It was commissioned by Lord Leverhulme, who owned the island of Lewis from 1918 to 1923. What he wanted to do was join up Tolster, where I just was a few minutes ago, to Ness, where I'm going, with a nice beautiful road. But with the World War and people coming back wanting to set up crofts and all that, it kind of conflicted with what the locals wanted, so it never actually went ahead. But this is the Bridge to Nowhere, which for me is the bridge to the end of my journey on the Outer Hebrides. So it's kind of ironic that this bridge is kind of known for going nowhere, but for me is the beginning of the end. So looking forward to getting off the track. As you can see, the road finishes and it just turns into a little track and it slowly diminishes into nothing about a mile further on, and that's where I'll be running for the rest of today. So looking forward to cracking on. But what a beautiful wee bridge. This is where the adventure in adventure running gets a little bit more involved. I've been following this trail. It was a road and then it became a track and then it became a kind of thing, and now it's turning into nothing. This is the little take care sign telling you that you need to have waterproof boots, which I don't have. So it's about, I don't know, 8 to 10 miles. I have no idea because I didn't really do any research on this. In that direction, what could possibly go wrong? This is some of the hardest running I've ever had to do. The ground just constantly disappears underneath you. And with this backpack on, whew, it's just jumping all over the place and cutting into my cuts every time I leap from one mound to another. And you think you see a nice firm piece of ground. Oh God, it's not. You just land straight on something that squishes away into nothing, and you're just, oh, just left with a foot, sunk about a foot further into the mud than you thought you were going to be. It's hard, and what makes it harder is you look out in front of you and there's nothing. Nothing for as far as the eye can see. I have no idea which direction this is going in. Oh no, it's just follow pole to pole. But this is, it's hard work, really hard work. It's a thing. I've run from the south of the Hebrides, some 200 and something kilometres that way, over the last 5 days. I ran, say, 18 kilometres this morning, and now I'm tackling this. The old legs are saying, come on, pal, what's the deal here? But they know just to keep going. So, just gonna power on through. You can see the horizon, and the horizon is where you get to see the next part of the adventure. I hope this is working. I've just lost my foot. It's in the ground. My foot is in the ground somewhere. I don't know how to get out. Here we go, the video. That I did not see happening. Well, I did see it happening, but I didn't see it was happening there. Rightio, time to carry on. I think I'm saying ow more than anything right now, but it's got to be worth it. Look at this. Everywhere I step, I lose a leg or a twisted ankle, but I get to experience this. This is the payoff. I just hope my legs are all right when I get to the other end. I am going to go up there. Jump has just come on my stereo, and I can't think of a more apt music for here. Jump. And someone had told me about buses being used as bothies, and I'm guessing this is it, because I've run the full length of the Outer Hebrides now, pretty much. And this is a bothy. See if anyone's in here. Oh. So, as you can see, this is where people can come and sleep. Or probably do drugs and get drunk, fornicate, all of the above. But this, it's probably the green bus that I've been told about where people come and sleep. I'm really starting to struggle. Really starting to struggle. My body is imploding. I've done just coming up to 42 kilometers today, a marathon. But about 12 of that was through a bog, and I'm just running on empty. There is a lighthouse. That marks the end of the island of Lewis, which is the top of the Outer Hebrides. I can't stop running until I get there, because if I do, I won't be able to start again. There it is. That's the end. That's the end. That's the end. That's the end. Come on, come on. Fucking hell. Oh my God. The end of the Outer Hebrides, and I nearly fell and tripped and fell down that cliff. That would have been unceremonious, but it's good that my arrival here was with an expletive, because that's how I feel. Done. Done. When you've run however many kilometers I've run, 6 days at over 40 kilometers a day, you dream about what the end's going to be like. You hope it's going to be beautiful, and you hope it's going to be worth the effort, the pain, the struggle, the
smelliness, the grime. And when you get to a place like this, could not be a more perfect way to finish the Outer Hebrides run. It's an utterly gorgeous blue sky. There's not a breath of air. There are no insects. It's just breathtaking. So glad to be here. But this is only stage one. I've still got stage two to do, which is the Isle of Skye. Can't hang around here forever. The downside. So I'm back in Tarbert, where I was about 3 days ago, I think. Just got the bus here from Stornoway because I'm getting a ferry, which will be here soon, to the Isle of Skye, where I will continue running. I just was on a bus for 1 hour and I feel so car sick. That's probably why I run everywhere. But this is the beautiful port of Tarbert. Goodbye, Outer Hebrides. You have been amazing. Onwards and across to the Isle of Skye, part two of my running adventure. This is the Isle of Skye, and this is where stage two of my running expedition is going to take place. Hopefully over the next 3 to 4 days, I'll be running up around the top of this, down the east side of Skye, and then cross to the mainland. Very sad. So, part two of running Scotland. The plan today is to take this road, which is a very harsh start because it's a switch back over to the other side. I'm going to aim up north. There's a castle I want to pop in and see, and then I'm going to switch around the top of Skye, come down, and then take a wee trail off up to the right, up to a place called the Kerrang. It started raining. One could probably expect that. So, trying to seek out a bit of shelter, I have found a storage unit from the Iron Age, which is here. I was going to send my torch home the other day. I knew there was a reason to keep it. So, torch on, and let's go and have a look in here. It is incredibly tight, and I can't really see anything, but ow. Oh, right, slight problem, it's full of water. This is, I don't know if you can see, this is an Iron Age storage unit, which you can just bolt it out, 300 to 300 BC to 300 AD. Sadly, it is too full of water to actually enter. As you can see, this is what it looks like. Time to get out. This is freaking genius. So this storage unit from the Iron Age is flooded with water, but some clever people have left welly boots, so you can actually go in and have a look. So, never one to shy away from a challenge. Let's give it a go. Let's hope that my size. Hey, bingo! They fit. Right, I have no idea if this is a good idea or a bad idea, but let's just go with the flow. Head torch, replacing sunglasses. Welly boots on. Let's descend into the cave. Oh. Ah, ow, ow. Right, if this gets too deep, we're gonna stop. Oh, look at this! The wellies are working! I am in a this is as far as I can go, I think. These wellies are gonna overflow. This is just full of water and wellies. Wellies! I'm not gonna go much further. I'm trying to creep along the edge. Whoa! Christ, I'm a runner! Not a caver. This is freaking cool. Look along here.
17 metres long in total. Unfortunately, I don't think with this amount of water I'm going to be able to go much further without getting the wellies overflow. But look at that. Wow. A Stone Age place. And I'm in it. This is cool. But the wellies back. It's pretty beautiful. It may be raining. Good old traditional Scottish weather not letting me down, but look at that. Cracking. Tullum Castle on the very north of Skye. Unfortunately, this is structurally unstable, and for your safety, you're requested to stay on this line of the fence boundary. So, that is the castle. Can't really show you much more. But what is amazing is the scenery around here. And it's drastically different to that of the Outer Hebrides. In the Outer Hebrides, it was all like bogland and heather and gorse and just that kind of much harsher environment. But here it's much more kind of grass, just grass and rock. And my run is now going to take me around past this wee town here, over the back, and then down behind that big rock over there where hopefully I'm going to camp tonight. The problem is I'm actually feeling really good. I didn't really want to run too far today. I was going to use today as some kind of like rest day thing, but I'm feeling quite good. I'm quite enjoying myself. I'm also enjoying the fact that over here is a hotel that might do tea and cake, and again I'm somehow managing to put weight on while running extreme distances. That is just purely from an increased cake intake. It is spectacularly good fun running here. Little single track roads, a little bit of rain to keep you cool, just perfect temperature, and just banging out the strides at the moment, which is fantastic. I found somewhere. There's no one here. Time to go skinny dipping. Oh, God. Oh, yeah. Skinny dipping in Scotland. Woo! It is cold. When people ask why I go on these ridiculous running expeditions, this is why I do it. For moments like this, for scenery like this, for running 6 days through rocky, ragged, awesome landscapes like this. It's so I can be here doing this right now. This is just the most beautiful terrain ever. Scotland, I freaking love you. Let me show you what this running's all about. Need I say more? How frickin' beautiful. Hello? Echo? From here, I'm gonna choose my camping spot. I've decided that this will be my campground for tonight. Good shelter, beautiful rocks, and a spectacular view. I think I can put up with a bit of cheap shit for that. This is my camping spot for tonight. Hi, neighbour.
My idyllic camping spot has turned into a rather rainy situation. We're going to be testing the waterproofing of my tent and kicking back and relaxing with a packet of hot and spicy cheddar cheese with delicious Scotch oats cake. Oat cakes.
Run out of water, but I can hear it coming out of these hills, these cliffs. So I'm going to go and have a look and see if I can fill my bottle up from the water dripping directly from the mountain. So my search of water has brought me to this kind of eerie, echoey shower block in the middle of the Isle of Skye. So I'm going to try and get the water from here. Bear Grylls would probably have some really cool thing, but I've got a Highland Spring bottle. It's a bit wet, but the water is coming straight off the mountain. So if I manage to get the right place, I should... There we go. Yeah, I can fill my water bottle.
It's like trying to catch raindrops. It's just really big raindrops.
Come on, go in my bottle! Why can you go everywhere but my bottle?
Is there a cooler way to get a glass of water in the morning? Straight off the cliff face into my bottle. I'm not saying this is the most efficient way of getting water, but it's jolly good fun.
I'm so tired. My little legs are dying today. But that is the old man of Storr. The old man of Storr!
Arrived in Portree today. I've done about 32 kilometres and I've come across
the Portree Isle of Skye Highland Games.
And I'm going to run with these guys here
in front of this awesome audience here. Look at these people.
My first foray into Highland Games. I got myself a wee medal for coming last, but it's a wee medal nonetheless. So I did a nice kind of 40 something kilometres today, stuck in some Highland Games in the middle, and decided that I'd finish today with a nice 3 mile walk along this trail that takes you along the side of this loch. I don't actually know how to pronounce it, but Slickachan or something like that. It's got a little bit more difficult than I thought it was going to be. A little bit tricky. Muscles crying out after my heroic entry into the Skye Highland Games, which I won a medal for!
Last night I made it to this campsite here, which was hell. So many people. And some really nice Spanish people woke up at 6:30 this morning making lots of noise. But the biggest nemesis here is midges. Midges everywhere. You just stop and your face is like, midges! So I have 30 something miles to go. This is the scenery of where I am, which is pretty darn amazing. Unfortunately, I have no food. Nada. I have one banana energy thing. So I'm gonna have to follow the A road down here, through there, and all the way back that way for 16 miles to get to a co-op where I can buy some food. So that's what I want to do. I twisted my ankle yesterday, so I'm a wee bit in pain. Roadside treat. It was a donut, but it's dissolved into its constituent parts of sugar. I don't want to know how much sugar is in a donut. Let's see if we can remake a donut. So, there we go. It's kind of holding together. My hand's going to be sticky as hell from now on, but this is what I'm going to eat. This is my treat! So I've just decided to kick on down to Armadale today, a day early. I'm kind of doing it 9 days. But what I've decided to do is to carry on past the ferry, right to the end of Skye. I'm actually going to extend my run and I'm going to come all the way down here
and I'm going to get to this point here.
I'm going all the way to the end, baby. All the way to the end. Blue sky running. That's the way I'm going to take this adventure, because I don't want it to stop. What a score. Just been given a free hunk of cheese by the lady in the shop here because it goes out of date today. What a marvellous little treat to mark the last night of camping on my trip. Love cheese, love it, love cheese, cheese. Mwah. Managed to run 50 kilometers today, and I'm now near the end of Skye. So this is tomorrow's last little jaunt, where I'm just gonna go down the coastline here, and there's a lighthouse at the end, and that will be the end of this run, this expedition, this adventure. So I am at the very end of Skye. It's just there. And look at this. It's an Honesty Cafe. Honesty Cafe. £1 for drinks, and there's sugar and coffee and hot water and mugs. And it said home baking, but I think the home baking's all been taken. Boo! But this is cool. I'm gonna see if the water's hot enough to have a cup of coffee. When you think of Scotland, you don't think about white sandy beaches like this. This is awesome. Look at this. Silky, lovely, beautiful sand. And the sea is turquoise. The sun is trying to get out this blue sky. 9 days of running. The full length of the Outer Hebrides and the full length of Skye. A big kind of V shape upside down. And this is me at the end of the Isle of Skye, the lighthouse we have here, a rather modern affair. But this is the end of my running, the end of my adventure. Well, the end of this part of my adventure. I've got to somehow get back to London from here, and that ain't easy. Really ain't easy, and it's going to take nearly 2 days to do. But it is all absolutely worth it, because I am in the most glorious place. It's been raining all morning, and then suddenly it's cleared up as I've got here. So I'm gonna sit, reflect, and enjoy this for a few minutes. All adventures have to come to an end, and this one is coming to an end. The sky disappearing behind me in the background. The mainland of Scotland ahead of me. Back on the train to London. Back to normal life. Thank you to Bailey Gifford for making this possible.